What's up, weebs? Welcome to the Call of Duty Modern Warfare multiplayer beta. I got to play this a little bit yesterday, and it's really fun. It really does remind me of, like, you know, Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3. But there are some things that are, like, weird about it, and some gripes I have, but it definitely is Call of Duty. There's just some good things and bad things that come with it. You know, some of the guns, I think I said this in my last video, a lot of the guns are meatier in that they have more kick to them, and that they sound and feel more like, you know, actual guns. But in this video today, I'm going to talk about some gripes, some problems I have with the game, but I'm also going to try to explain both sides of the game, why I don't like this, but why it could possibly be a thing, you know. And the first thing I want to talk about is solo queuing. If you ever play Call of Duty, you know, playing it by yourself is a terrible idea. It's the worst thing you can possibly do. It's immediate setup for a bad time. Anytime you just load into a lobby by yourself, it's not the most fun, especially if you're bad like me. And you'll notice in the gameplay, I'm pretty bad at this game. But just solo queuing by yourself, it really doesn't feel that great, because it's either one, it's a super one-sided fight. The enemy team is just like full of, it's an entire squad or clan, and then your team just, it feels like they don't do anything, but it's just the other team is just so well coordinated and you can't really do anything on a team with no communication or anything. But that just really, that comes with when you just play the game by yourself and don't really try to link up with any friends. The second thing is the time to kill. This is dependent. The time to kill on some guns is super strange. Like, it feels super inconsistent. This could be just because I'm bad at aiming. But it sometimes it feels like the M4, like it'll be a 3 to chest, 1 life. And then the next time I try to kill somebody, it'll be a 4 to the chest instead. Or the MP7, which is still one of my favorite submachine guns, will be like a 2 or 3 taps to the head. And then the next time it'll be a 4 or 5. Now, to be fair, that could be just me missing a lot of my bullets. But it just sometimes it does feel a little inconsistent. A super obvious one here, the third one, is it's not going to be fun until you get create a class. Obviously, the default classes are kind of whack. There's probably one good one, but being held to just one good default class doesn't really feel that great. But the next one here is a big one. The gunsmith is a really cool thing in create a class. It lets you create one of the weapons you want, like, specifically, and it really gets you down to, like, the grip you want, the stock you want. It really lets you make your own gun. It reminds me of, like, I forget the name, but it was an old Ghost Recon game in 360. It was super fun. Another one is the spawns are exactly like every other Call of Duty, where they get mixed up super easily. One teammate will go all the way into the enemy spawn and will just flip it on the other side, and it just completely screws everything up. It throws off the flow of the entire game, but I get it. It's to, like, prevent spawn trapping or just berate, just one-sided berates from one team. But there's no, like, it's tough to, like, feel it out when it happens, because once it happens, it, like, the entire team is behind you, like, in an instant, and it's super Call of Duty. It's always happened, and it's probably always gonna happen. Finding spawns on the map is super tough, I guess, when making a game. The next thing I want to talk about is group fights. It feels like every gunfight you get into, be it by yourself or you're in a team, anytime you get in a fight, there will be at least 2 to 3 people in that fight. Like, you'll go and you'll see one guy in front of you, But then you won't know there's another one behind you, to the left, to the right, or right next to him. There's always going to be a second person who you're going to have to worry about shooting. There's always going to be the second person that'll get you right after you get the kill. It happens in Call of Duty. It's the thing you have to look out for when playing such a fast-paced game, especially in things like Team Deathmatch and Domination. And the last thing I really want to have, like, lined up to talk about is the quote-unquote lag, because it definitely, at least in the beta, it definitely feels like the beta, either I do have bad internet, but definitely feels like it's not on dedicated servers, because there's definitely times where I'm ice skating, where bullets don't connect on direct hits, or the kill cam shows something completely different than what I saw before I died. I don't think Call of Duty's done dedicated servers before. I'm not too sure. I should have probably looked that up. But it could really ruin the enjoyment of the game, because I'm not going to want to play if it's just lagging like every time, back to back to back. It's gonna ruin the experience. Another thing I want to talk about is maps. The maps are super cool. There's this shipping yard one that's pretty fun. It's Call of Duty says it didn't. I guess somewhere they said that they don't want to do 3-lane maps, but at least the shipping yard one feels super 3-lane. Like, there's absolutely 3 lanes in that map. There's another one that reminds me of, I don't know if you guys remember Wasteland in Modern Warfare 2, with the big cave in the middle, but there's one that is kind of the same, where it mixes, ooh, you know what, it's actually more like the Afghan map, where it's kind of like some slums outside, and then there's a cave where a lot of the action might happen. That map's super cool. There's a, what was the other map I played? Oh no, I'm blanking on the last map I played. Maybe it was, I don't remember. If it comes back to me in the middle of the thing, I'll probably blurt it out, but the maps are pretty good. They have this new, I don't know if World War II had it. I know Black Ops 4, I think it had it in multiplayer. I played mostly Black Ops 4, so I wouldn't know too much, but it has, you know, opening and closing doors, so you can like create gaps of like cover, or you can just, during a gunfight, you can close the door, like calm down and reload and really get your bearings right. So that's really good. It kind of like changes the flow a lot, changes the pace of the fight, where you just completely cut off bullets, unless I think FMJ can actually go through those. So far, Modern Warfare is feeling like it's lining up to be a pretty fun Call of Duty this year. I didn't play World War II that much. I'm super tired of Black Ops, I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not really about the whole futuristic thing and the whole, like, you know, Destiny Supers type thing in multiplayer. That being said, Modern Warfare does have the Supers type thing, but it's with real stuff and not like these, like, what's that dude's name? Ruin? His, like, Titan Slams or the Tempest Wonder Waffle gun. It's not like those. There's, like, you get deployable ammo, you get mobile cover, there's things you can get like that. And it helps during the game, because you can go on a super big kill streak and then you run out of ammo, and then boom, you can throw your deployable ammo. Or you can be like in the middle of a lane and people come up and you just throw down your deployable cover and you have something to hide behind. It's not a super like get 4 kills in 2 seconds like ability. It's like an actual tool, which that makes more sense to me than like crazy superpowers. The last thing probably in the beta I want to talk about is the game chat. I think the game chat would be better if it was forced, like most people do, because it comes back to the old Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, like shit talking scene. And that's where you get the real good, that's when you get the real good times, because people just like to talk shit that they're better than you, you're better than them. And especially during like Search and Destroy or Sabotage, those are really where the good moments came. But I'm really thinking that Modern Warfare, I don't know what to call this, like a reboot, a remake. It's gonna be probably one of my more favorite Call of Duties of recent years. Like, I didn't really like a Call of Duty since Modern Warfare 3, and I think that's like 2013. So, this is gonna be a good call. I think, for me at least, this is looking to be a good Call of Duty. I'm hoping I can enjoy it. I'm hoping you guys can enjoy it. But I'm gonna end the video here. This has been super weird. I'm recording this in a different format, and I don't really know if this is gonna sound even good at all. But if it does, let me know. Let me know if you want me to talk about more games like this at all. Play more Call of Duty beta, because I'm gonna. It still has like a day or two. Actually, this might go up on like Monday, so it'll probably be over by then. So let's ignore that last part. But let me know any other games you guys want me to play. I do want to branch out a little bit. But anyways, if you guys like the video, make sure to like the video. Subscribe if you want to see more like this. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.